أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه All praises and thanks and glorifications belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala The all compassionate, the all merciful, the all forgiving, the all loving The possessor of the most severe, the severest of punishment subhanahu wa ta'ala The all thankful, who thanks those who are thankful to him. And he is thankful to those who show gratitude to others. In fact, it's a sign of being gratitude to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith that I'm going to mention later, inshallah ta'ala. And what I just said leads us into the topic, which is it fi sabeelillah? Or is it free Sabeelillah? Let me say the R with an Arabic way, free with an R, right? Job or something in South Africa, you hear the R, which is a skill, by the way. I won't talk about it now, I'll talk about it later, inshallah ta'ala, as we go with time. This is like the system, and being here is new to me, so inshallah I'm getting used to it, and you'll get used to me, inshallah. Hopefully I'll continue to give the second Jum'ah every Friday, in Allah ta'ala. So when someone is of a high rank in the community, someone who's respectable, for whatever reason it is, be it their qualifications, be it their community service, and they don't demand respect from others in certain times, this does not mean that we devoid them or we strip them of that respect when respect is required. Someone who's humble does not mean that we abuse their humility, right? Someone who's asked to do something which is in their field, that is what they studied for, and then they present or do that, give you that service in the best way possible, and then they shy to kind of ask for some remuneration or compensation for their time, because they're humans, they have needs, just like us. They have rent, they have electricity, they have kids, go to school, etc. Just like us, right? And then we abuse this, saying it's fi sabilillah. We'll get to that, inshallah ta'ala. Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala, says, وَدِدْتُ أَنَّ النَّاسَ تَعَلَّمُوا هَذَا الْعِلْمَ وَلَا يُنْسَبُ إِلَيْهِ شَيْءٌ وَلَا يُنْسَبُ إِلَيَّ شَيْءٌ مِنْهُ أَبَدًا فَأُوجَبُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَا يَحْمِدُونَنِ He says, I would have loved, Imam Shafi'i, you know, the legend, the one who left us books, he died, he was born in the year 150 when Imam Abu Hanifa passed on, and then he, Imam Shafi'i, passed on 204 Hijri. He lived 54 years. He left us books that scholars still use until now. Which scholar or student of knowledge does not know Kitabul the mother, Al-Risala? Which youth who grew up in a spiritual environment does not relate to the poetry, to the Diwan of Imam Shafi'i. Yet he says about himself, I would have loved that people learn this knowledge that I have left, that Allah enabled me to leave. And I wouldn't want them to ascribe this legacy, these books to me. Why? He said, I would like to get rewarded from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they don't praise me for it, right? I said, Imam Shafi'i said this. By the way, if I may, just a side point. Some brothers, some sisters, you find them on the social media, they write say that certain quotes, right? It's not theirs, and they not put this quotation marks, right? And people will praise them, give them likes and comments. MashaAllah, wonderful. And the brother or the sister, they're accepting the praise. I don't understand. In the Quran, it says in Surah Ali Imran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم لا تحسبن الذين يفرحون بما أتوا ويحبون أن يحمدوا بما لم يفعلوا فلا تحسبنهم بمفازة من العذاب The gist of it, to the end of the ayah, that those who are happy with what they, what happened to them, what they did, right? And they like to be praised for that which they didn't do. Praise for that which they didn't do. Don't think they are spared from the punishment, right? So when you're taking this credit, what are you going to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You don't know the person, just put there لِقَائِلِهِ for the person who said it. And مع ذلك, with the honor of Imam Shafi'i, with the humility of Imam Shafi'i, مِنْ حَقِّيَّ عَلَيْنَا أَنْ نَنْسُبَ عِلْمَهُ إِلَيْهِ. It's his right upon us to ascribe his knowledge to him. رَحِمَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى لِأَنَّ فِي هَذَا بَرَكَةٌ لَنَا. When we ascribe and quote those people who said such things, it is a barakah for us. What is barakah? الشيء الذي يزيد وينمو تبارك الذي بيده الملك. Barakah is something that grows and increases, not grows and stops. It keeps increasing. That's a barakah for you, because you mentioned that someone will come and mention your name as well. قال ابن عبد البر رضي رحمه الله تعالى, one of the great scholars who passed on in the year 436 Hijri in the Andalus, in the Maghrib, في بيان العلم وفضائله, a great book about knowledge and its merits. قال يقال أن من بركة العلم أن تضيف الشيء إلى قائله. The barakah, the blessing of knowledge, that you ascribe the saying to the one who said it. Imam Qurtubi, I found many sayings about this because it really annoys me. It bothers you. You have to talk about it. These things we highlight in order to remind ourselves and others. Imam Qurtubi, rahimahullah ta'ala, the great Mufassir, who passed on 671 after Hijra, he says about his tafsir. Listen carefully. قَالَ وَشَرْطِي فِي هَذَا الْكِتَابِ. My condition of this book, his tafsir, إِضَافَةُ الْأَقْوَالِ إِلَىٰ قَائِلِهَا وَالْأَحَدِيثِ إِلَىٰ مُصَنِّفِيهَا فَإِنَّهُ يُقَالُ مِنْ بَرَكَةِ الْعِلْمِ أَنْ يُضَافَ الْقَوْلُ إِلَىٰ قَائِلِهِ. He said, because my condition is everything I mention, every hadith, every tradition, I am telling you where it came from. This is it. And then he quoted what Ibn Abd al-Barr said, rahimahullah ta'ala, that this is the barakah of knowledge. And other imams, Imam Nawawi, rahimahullah ta'ala, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, and many of them, they have the same, subhanallah, the same opinion. And it's very important also. I've got to another point. It's a side point which is really important. Talking about social media, Facebook, WhatsApp, whatever it is. You receive a hadith. قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And all us Muslims, when we hear this saying, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what do you do? What did he say? We love him, alayhi wa sallam. Listening to him, to his, this is an obligation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you look at the content of the hadith, and some scholars of hadith, I believe Imam Ahmad is a specialist of hadith sciences. Imam Ahmad, the Imam of this masjid, they will smell ra'ihatul wad'i. They'll smell the fabrication. So my beloved brother, my respected sister, before you send this nuclear button, I go to all your contacts, verify. Who said that? Because Quran is absolute. قَطْعِيُّ الدِّلَالَةِ. Nobody can play with the words of the Quran. Allah has, subhanahu wa ta'ala, promised to preserve it. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. But the sunnah, yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also promised to preserve the sunnah, because the sunnah is inseparable from the Quran. That's why we have the sahih books, the authentic books, etc., etc. So on and so forth. So before you send, verify. Because if someone receives this hadith or this saying that your highness has sent, your mashallah, you are a scholar now, mashallah, you have a good intention, alhamdulillah, you don't realize the responsibility, and they act upon that hadith, who's going to carry that? I don't want to say sin because it's unintentional, but the misunderstandings, the mispractices, etc. It would be you. Let me quote the great scholar Abdullah ibn Mubarak, who is described as Amirul Mu'mineen of Hadith, the leader of believers in the sciences of Hadith. And Imam Muslim quotes this in his Muqaddimah of Sahih. So I'm telling you where it came from. I don't want to contradict myself. He said, Rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, الإسناد من الدين. لولا الإسناد لقال من شاء ما شاء. إسناد, that chain of narrations in our religion. This is the core, from the core of our religion. Had it not been for this system which only Muslims have, alhamdulillah, Allah knows, we need this to preserve the Quran. Quran, I have my ijazah all the way to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Same in all other fields, in hadith, in whatever it is. Chain. So he said, had it not been for the chain of narrators, anybody would say anything. So I hope we get this, inshallah ta'ala. Then we move on. We still have time. قضيه مهمه. This is an important issue to talk about. تواضع صاحب الحق او الفضل لا يعني ان نبخس حقه او فضله. As I said earlier, someone shows humility, right, does not mean we abuse his or her humility, his or her kindness, his or her benevolence, because at the end we're abusing ourselves. انظروا قدر اهل العلم. Let's look at the rank of the people of knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Imran, ayah number 18, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just listen, the honor and the rank of the people of knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bears witness that there is no God but Him, as do the angels and those who possess knowledge. Look at the rank. He subhanahu wa ta'ala upholds justice. There is no God but Him, the Almighty, the All-Wise, subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was a young imam, something happened in Brisbane years ago. Told me he was a new graduate. So he came to speak to one of the senior imams. Just to say, really, وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ. Above every possessor of knowledge is someone who knows more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-knowing, right? So this young imam comes to the senior imam. And he says, Monsab, Monsab, whatever it is, right? He says, you've written this ayah somewhere, it's in public, and you have put the translation that it is to show the greatness of the people of knowledge, because it can be abused by them. People of knowledge, people of rank can abuse this. So that young imam said, you put that Allah, the angels, and the people of knowledge are upholding justice. So the senior imam said, no, you know, I studied here, there has nothing. You know, like someone came to one of the gatherings of one of the khalifas and he mentioned the hadith. Another scholar said, I didn't hear this hadith. He said, did you hear all the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Really? He said, no. Anyway, so this young imam said, okay, please have a look at it. He had a look at the translation and it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who was upholding justice. So people of knowledge, they're not above everybody else. They get their respect from the knowledge that they hold and the way they represent it. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu used to say, let's just come to mind, he said, Kunu du'atan ila Allah bisamtin. Call to Allah quietly. How? Qala bi akhlaqikum, through your character, through your behavior. Another example quickly. When an ambassador, when an ambassador goes to a country to represent his or her country for a certain period of time, they get certain privileges, right? Let that ambassador go to the same country after they've been either demoted or they retaliated. Let them go to the same country. Will they have the same respect? Absolutely not. So there is an honor and there is a responsibility as well. All right. There's a story I'd like to mention about this, inshallah. Al-Hadith رواه أبو داود رحمه الله تعالى قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنزل الناس منازلهم. He said treat people according to their ranks. The hadith has a story. I looked it when I looked it up. I found the story. I mean, some ulama اختلفوا في تصحيحه وتضعيفه ولكن المعنى صحيح. Some ulama said authentic. Some ulama said not that authentic or a little bit weakness in the chain of narration. But the meaning is true or is correct. عن ميمون بن أبي شبيب. Let's listen to the story. That's the problem because he didn't see عائشة رضي الله عنها. Anyway, مر بها سائر. A beggar passed by our mother عائشة رضي الله عنها وعن أمهات المؤمنين وعن أصحاب رسول الله أجمعين. مر بها رجل. مر بها سائر. A beggar passed by her فأعطته كسرة. She gave him a piece of bread. That's it. ومر بها رجل. Later on, a man passed by her. عليه ثياب وهيئة. The man is well dressed. The man looks of a respectable, you know, rank or stature, etc. فأقعدته. She made him sit. Right? فأكل. She served him food. فقيل لها في ذلك. They noticed. This is double standards or something. How come? You gave him a piece of bread. This man asked him to come and sit down and you gave him food. By the way, she did not personalize the issue. You ask, oh, how dare you ask me? I'm the mother of the believers. No, none of us are above that. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked for clarification many times. And he gave the clarification, alayhi wa sallam. Right? So she didn't get upset. She didn't take it personal. فقالت, she said to them, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم I did what I did obviously because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said أنزل الناس منازلهم treat people according to their own ranks. She gave the answer, it was from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Somebody gives you their reply, Allah said سبحانه وتعالى, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, then we respect that. Even if you may differ with that kind of understanding, there's no problem because our foundations are the same. Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, Shaykh Yuzkar, and sometimes one thing leads to another. When he used to go and debate with somebody, right? He used to say, Allahumma adhir al-haqqa ala lisanihi li-aqbalahu. Oh Allah, this opponent of mine, I'm making dua to Allah. To making dua to have a match or something. Ya Allah, make us win. They'll make him. My kids would come and say, Ya Allah, I have a soccer match. Please make dua. And then I make dua. Ya Allah. And then he comes. All your duas work today. The Prophet ﷺ says, dua wal walidi li waladihi la yurad. When a father, mother make dua for their children, it's not rejected. So anyway, subhanallah. So we need to remember these beautiful examples as our mother Aisha, she treated that man according to his rank. For example, I'll end with this because my time is very limited. We'll continue next week, inshallah. Would you treat a homeless person with the same respect that you treat all? We all deserve respect, with utmost respect to them. Right? And may Allah bless the sisters and brothers here in Brisbane and elsewhere who are working with the homeless. What an honorable service you are providing. May Allah bless you and may Allah give you barakah. You'll see this barakah in your life and in generations, inshallah ta'ala. Right? But this is a homeless person who's been on the street, right? Who expects certain, give him a few things like our mother Aisha did, alhamdulillah, I'm happy. And you see social experiments, you'll be amazed. How honest they are, because you cannot judge a book by its cover. Right? This is a homeless person, and then you get someone who comes to you. He used to be a CEO of a company. He was earning a lot of money, as well as all the other benefits. COVID-19 came, he lost his job. He had all kind of commitments to give, right? And he or she does not want to ask others out of self-respect. لا يسألون الناس إلحافا, Allah says about them, those people. You think يحسبهم الجاهل أغنياء من التعفف. The ignorant will think those people are أغنياء, self-sufficient, rich, because of their dignity. They never ask. When you treat that person, the amount you give, the same amount like you give the homeless person? No. This person has needs, has commitments, is in debt up to his neck because of legitimate things. So this is what our mother has. So we have to treat people according to their ranks. Now the Prophet, I'm going to get to the part of fi sabeelillah straight away and free sabeelillah. I was going to say basically, I'll conclude inshallah, we'll continue next week. It's so ironic. من المفارقات العجيبة يعني المطلوب من الشيخ أو الإمام أو المعلم أن يعطي وقته في سبيل الله وننسى أن نعطيه لوقته في سبيل الله. Ironic. We ask the Imam, the Sheikh, the teacher, the community worker to give their times in the way of Allah, in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we forget that also giving them for their time is also fi sabilillah. Don't ask me what you're not doing. It's a two-way road. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to be cognizant of this fact that He thanks those who thank others. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who give others their due respect. إنه سميع قريب وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.